Hello students, welcome to application developments using Python classes. So the first module, next topic is the programming example, your first program on Python. So earlier we have discussed about the interactive shell, right? How does the Python interactive shell behaves. Yes. So while the interactive shell is good for running Python instructions one at a time, to write entire Python program, you will have to type the instruction into a file editor. Right? The file editor is similar to the text editor such as the Notepad or TextMate. Notepad you are familiar with. Earlier, what we have seen is using command prompt, we tried entered single command at a time and we were accessing the output. That is different. Now thing is, we are going to write an entire program, just like your C or Java program. The multiple lines of code are written at one side and they are saved. So using text editor like Notepad, we can do this. Okay. So we have taken the example of MU editor here for Python. Okay, along with the KyPython compiler. So to open a new file in MU, click on new button on the top row. This I'll illustrate, I'll demonstrate the same soon, okay? I'll make the video also of the same, and once I install it, I'll make a note video and I'll demonstrate it. So you can try it even in your laptop as well. Please try, remember these steps. Very simple, how you are creating a new file, no, in C and all, using once you open the editor, click on new and all to create a new file in the same way. Okay, it's just like a Notepad. The window that appears should contain the cursor awaiting for your input, but it is different from the interactive shell which runs Python instruction as soon as you press enter. So the interactive shell, what it does is, it simply executes the command, Python instruction, once you press enter and all. Earlier we have seen that. So interactive shell, in the command prompt, it is ready to accept the input, user input. It can be in data or command, right? So three right arrows will be displayed in the interactive shell. If you press 2 plus 3, so what it does, it simply go does the computation and give the produce the result in the next line once you press enter. So here it is something different, since it is an editor. So you will be like inside the editor and you are typing the things. Once you press enter, you will be moving to the next line. This is the general scenario, common scenario. Okay. The interactive shell windows will always be the one with the, see the prompt, that prompt, which prompt it is, we have seen it. Okay. The file editor window will not be having that prompt because it contains multiple lines of code. Please try to understand. That was on command prompt we are operating. Now we are not operating it on command prompt. Instead, we are working on editor mode. Okay. So on editor, this command or prompt will not be displayed. So you can write the comment line here. Comment line, how you are writing comment line in C and C++ using double slash and all. Here it is different. You are supposed to use a hash symbol for comment. So hash, after hash, anything you write, it is treated as comment. So this program says hello and ask for username or my name, whatever. So the first line, line number, this is for your reference. Okay, this 1, 2, 3 and all for your reference purpose. Please try to understand. So line number one, what it does, this program says hello and ask for my name or username. Okay, this is the comment line. Line number two is the print command. There is a print command. See, observe carefully how to use the print command and all. Print followed by how you are writing printf in C. The open and closing brackets are required. In the same way, you have to put open and closing bracket inside. String should be mentioned within single quote, not in double quote. Earlier it was double quote with respect to different programming language like C, Java or whatever. But here it is single quote. Please try to understand and observe the syntax carefully. Okay, then print, what is your name? Once again, one more line number three. Oh, it is the continuation of print command, so it is not marked as three here. Whatever, you can just continue or you can write it in the next line. There is no semicolon as a termination and all. There is no semicolon and all for termination. Please understand and please try to observe all these important things. So print what is your name. It print what it does is it simply prints hello world first followed by ask it ask you your name. What is your name is so ask for their name is the comment line. Then so many functions we are supposed to study later. So one is the print function, second one is the input function. Input this does like scanf. So why you have used scanf earlier? It is used for read purpose, right? Here input function does the same. Input is the name of the function, input followed by open and closing bracket. The input value should be stored somewhere in a variable. Use some variable. Name of the variable can be anything. Here name of the variable we have used as my name. Okay, it can be A, B or single letter or set of letters as a common string. So just a variable. My name is a variable which holds the My name is a variable which holds the what it holds. It holds the input name given by you. Next, say the print command is used once again. Print function is used. It is good to meet you will be printed. Along with that, something will be appended. What will be appended? Recall Java concept. Appending, using appending is done with the help of the plus, isn't it? So plus my name which does what? Suppose it is good to meet you. Suppose Vibhav is trying. Assume Vibhav is trying this program. So what is your name? We will later on know Vibhav will be entering his name. So input will be VIBHA Vibhav, that is assigned to my name. Okay. Now next statement is what? It is good to meet you will be displayed followed by who has what is the name? Username. Username is Vibhav, that is stored with my name. That content will be printed. It's good to meet you, Vibhav will be printed. Okay. Next I want to print the length of your name, Vibhav. What is the length of your name? VIBHAV, six letters, isn't it? That I want to print. The length of your name is the string I want to print first, followed by string length. How to print the string length? One more function we have, len. Earlier we had strlen. Recall your first year concept, first semester, right? I only taught all those things for you people. Just recollect them. So string for concatenation function, string length and all we have discussed it that time. Similar to that, here we are having the length function len, which calculates or which computes the length of the variable or string length, you can say. Name of the variable is my name, so len of my name which will compute the len of my name which will compute the string length, and print function will does the printing. That's it. So one function is embedded or written inside another function. Len is a function, print is the another function. So len of my name, carefully you observe which I am highlighting. So len of my name which computes the string length of username, say Vibhav. Okay, that result will be given. Same should be printed. No, use print function outside. So print of 6, that will give you the or display the 6 on the, that will display 6 on the screen as out. Next, I want to display some content, some string I want to. So what is your age? I am asking your age. Okay, suppose you enter 20. So this is for comment line, ask for the age, user age. Again, that 20 input function, call the input function. The value you have entered is stored with respect to input function. Assign it to different variable. My name which holds your name, my age now, my age which holds your age. That's it. Next, I want to print your age as it is. Now as it is, instead of printing your age as it is, I just want to increase it by one. That is your wish. Okay, it is not mandatory and all. It is just for demonstration purpose where you will be, say, what we are doing, integer value of your age, that 20. Okay, we are adding 1 to it. We are adding 1 to it and we are displaying the result along with the statement in a year. You will exactly come to know how does this function works in the description. So description is there below. Just observe the last line carefully. Okay, and let us see first how to save the program and how to compile it. See, C program is saved with respect to extension C extension, dot C extension. Java program is saved with respect to dot Java extension. Now, this is the Python program. It should be stored with respect to py extension. Very simple. So, click on save button and enter. Okay, while saving, you can rename the file as hello or as per whatever the file name it can be. Dot py is first. Okay, you can do this with the help of Control S and all. That is for saving. Then press F5 from editor window and all, you will be taken to the execution mode. So execution mode, these things will be displayed. First it display hello world because there is a print command. Okay, there is a print command. Check line number 2. Line number 1 is comment line. Print hello world. Hello world will be displayed followed by what is your name is asked. Right? So hello world is displayed. What is your name is asked. Assume you are entering TI. I have taken earlier what? Python, Vibhav I have taken. Let it be. Here in the textbook they have entered it as AI. See whatever you are entering, user is entering, they have marked it on bold just for your understanding purpose. Then next print command will be displayed. It is good to meet you followed by your name is printed. So AI in place of your name, AI you have given. Right. So this line number 4, line number 4. It is good to meet you followed by my name, that is AI. Right. Line number 4, it is good to meet you. My in place of my name, AI is stored. That is printed. Next, you are printing the length of name. So the length of your name is LEN. LEN of my name. LEN of my name is 2 here. Same is done with the help of the print command. So print of LEN of my name 2 will be displayed. Next question asked to you is what is your age? So this is entered by user. That's why it is given as bold, right? Highlighted 4. So you will be 4 plus 1 is 10 by this function. Which one? Don't get confused much. The last line, as I told you earlier, int of my age plus 1, convert it into string. That's it. Int of my age, integer value of my age. My age value, integer value is 5. Right? Whatever the value you have entered, they have entered 4, so 4 it is. So integer value of my age is 4. So typecasting is done. What of course you have entered integer only. If some float or something else is entered, convert it into integer. Add 1 to it. Suppose 4.5. If you entered, 4 will be accessed plus 1, 5. It is done. So 4 plus 1, 5. Convert it into string. Normal string, okay. You will be 5 in a year is the message printed. You will be 5 in a year is the message printed. After that, the prompt will be displayed. Okay. When there are no more lines of code to execute, the Python program will be terminated. That means it stops the execution. Okay. This is how to open the program and all again. It is there here. We'll demonstrate you. It is very simple. It is as simple as earlier how you have done your C programming and all file opening. Java also you have done, right? It depends on the editor what we are using or compiler what we are using. Of course, Python compiler is required and editor. There are multiple editors available. They have given the example of MU editor. Okay. Some sample program and visualization tool is available at pythontutor.com. You can see, you can go through. You can log on to the website and you can see the execution of the program. Some online compilers are also available. I'll try with those as well. But your job is to concentrate carefully all these topics and observe the program carefully. Okay. Next is dissecting your program. So this tells you about what exactly the things we have used in the previous program, the example program. 6 or 7 lines were there, no? We have marked with line number, right? 6 different lines are marked. What exactly the things are there in that program? That is what we are analyzing. First, we have a comment line, line number 1. So the following line is called as a comment. This is for your understanding purpose. A comment is prefixed with hash. Then we have the print function. The print function display the string value inside its parenthesis on the screen. That is line number 2. We have print function, print hello world. Hello world is marked as a string. There are single quotes enclosed, right? And what is your name is a string. Okay, so those things are explained here. Please go through them carefully. Then we have an input function. So the input function waits for the user to type some text on the keyboard and press enter. So input function, this halts for user input. Input function, this waits for the user input until and unless the user press some, user type something from the keyboard and press enter, it won't take you to the next line. I mean, next line will not be executed by the compiler. Okay, my name equal to input. I mean, here input function, the value of the input function is assigned to my name, and question is asked, what is your name, to the user. So user will come to know what type of input should be given. He cannot simply enter 1 2, right? 1 2. Even though if you enter 1 2, that will be assigned to my name. That's it. So if you enter a valid name, string, your name, like Vibhav or whatever AI we have entered here. Next, next thing is printing the username. So print, it is good to meet you. AI is printed. So it is good to meet you. If you want to append something, then use plus. That's it. Concatenation earlier we have done, no? With respect to our Java programming, we have done this, right? We have added something to the text existing value, use plus. So it's good to meet you. In place of my name, the value stored is accessed. That is, if it is Vibhav, Vibhav will be printed. Okay, here it is AI. AI will be printed. Then length function which will give you the string length, integer value. How many number of characters are there? Length function is provided, and print function does the printing, as I told you earlier. Okay. See here, examples are given. Len of hello will give you string length. Okay. Here string concatenation, I am 29 years old. 29 is not a string. So string concatenation, what we have discussed in the previous session, please observe, please remember carefully. You have to convert the 29 to string, then only concatenation is possible. Just in the previous session we have discussed, no? String concatenation and string replication. For concatenation you are using plus operator, plus, but both of them should be left, left operand and right operand should be string. If left operand is string and right operand is integer, then it will be an invalid. You will be end up with an error message. The same thing is explained once again. So type error, I am 29 is not a string here, years old. I am years old. There is, of course, it is a valid, they are valid string, but 29, IM plus 29 cannot be possible. 29 should be converted into string, then concatenation is possible, right? So that's why to string, that str we have, say str of 29. That is what we have done. I told you to observe the last line. carefully. I told you, right? Observe the last line carefully. We are converting the things that age, since age is an integer value, we are converting it to string. That's it. So conversion type, that is type casting, is very simple. How we are doing the type casting? Use print iam plus, that is string concatenation, str of 29, integer value 29 will be converted into string 29. That's it. 29 is now accessed as normal label, then it will be valid version. So str of 29 in concatenation with years old. So I am 29 years old will be printed. The same thing, for the same purpose, we have used the line, last line. I told you we have used the string function. See the last line carefully. See this one, print you will be plus integer value of my age, because float is converted into integer plus one is added if there is a float is entered, means. So integer or value of my age plus one, 4 plus 1, that 5. 5 is invalid. 5 is, I mean, you will be 5 years old, should be printed, but that 5 concatenation will not be possible. You will be is a string, 5 will be integer. So it should be converted into string using str function. So str of 5, the whole expression, check inside the bracket, integer value of my age plus 1. My age is entered by you as 4 as per this example, plus 1 is done. So 4 plus 1 is 5 is the integer value, is converted into string. That is, now string concatenation is possible, because left hand side operand will be string, right hand side operand will be string. So string concatenation is possible. You will be 5 in a year or 5 years old, whatever. Okay. Hope you have understood. So this completes your first chapter. So another two main topics are remaining from this chapter, sorry, from this module, that is chapter 2 content and chapter 3 contents. In the next session, I'll begin with chapter 2 contents. Please go through these descriptions carefully. Pause the video, okay? Pause the video, note down these contents. I have already shared the link with you all. Please go through them. If you have any doubt, any difficulty, feel free to ask. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.